There's so many good riders out there that might not always get an opportunity. So why not hold an event to put them through the paces so we have an opportunity to select the best rider for our 2019 season.
The whole concept of what this is all about is doing things differently to how it's always been done in the past.
Yeah, I love that what he's done in regards to getting the best bikes up with the best team, best mechanics, the best support staff, bringing in experts like the sports psychologists and the nutritionalists and the strength and conditioning coaches. What a better way to create a team that's going to be both strong mentally and physically and be able to go out and dominate a series of racing.
It's very difficult to get a funded ride, whether it's my team or any other team.
To get this ride would mean the world for me, you know, it's something I've been chasing for a very long time.
I feel like I've always just sort of always been an underdog or just under the radar. I've always just been off a factory team or off a team ride.
You kind of have to find that fine line between being as aggressive as you can be and not being too nice, because if you be too nice, people like to run in on you and take advantage. So you gotta be almost the man of the track.
It's hectic, more hectic than V8 supercars. It's more contact than rugby league. The start is, it's incredible. I mean, picture, you have 40 guys lined up across the gates.
You're sitting there taking deep breaths, you're almost not breathing, you're nervous, you're thinking of crazy things you wouldn't even think of.
You get the 30-second board, and then it drops to 5, and then anywhere from 0 to 5 seconds, the gate will drop, and 39 other riders will be racing to one tight corner.
The amount of dirt that gets sprayed out, you don't even realise it. You stand behind when those guys, that gate drops and the guys are going for it, that dirt will hit you from 30 metres away, and it stings. It's fast. It's super, super fast.
Sometimes you care, sometimes you don't.
It'll bring up emotions and fears in you that you probably can't experience anywhere else. I need to let you know that we've had one withdrawal, okay, and you'll notice his jersey has turned around. We also have Ryan Findanis, who on Tuesday suffered a knee injury.
I'm gutted. It's just had such a great opportunity in front of me and felt like I was going pretty well.
Unfortunately for Ryan, he will have to withdraw from this competition.
We want to see how far the athletes are willing to go to be able to get this ride. We want to see what it'll take to break him.
Our team is a little bit different. We started as a family.
It's just really nice to have that feeling to know they're basically like family.
Motocross is important to me, not just for the sport, it's more the athletes. I get a real buzz and a real kick out of being able to at least try my very best to give athletes an opportunity to do their best and follow their dreams.
I think I'm just driven by not having a lot growing up. And it was a thing that Mum and I always spoke about, because it was always an issue for me growing up. It was hard watching the boys race and me having to play soccer.
As a sport, if we want to produce champions, we've got to harness those young people and we've got to help follow them through all that way to give them that opportunity, not just for us, but for the country and for the sport.
The rider that's going to go all the way to the end is going to have to, they're going to have to basically tick all the boxes in terms of obviously, you know, speed and their bike skills. They're also going to have a very high coachability factor about them as well.
Hi guys.
Hey, Scotty.
Welcome to the final stage 2019 KSF Search for a Rider. The winner for our 2019 KSF Suzuki ride, which will be a fully funded ride, all by KSF, is